Melissa, and I'm the office manager and in charge of office operations for Executive Elevator. We're in Southern California, and we service, repair, and modernize elevators. We have about 600 elevators on service that we service every month. We service all of Southern California from San Diego to Tehachapi and from the coast inland to about Hemet. Executive Elevator has been using WorkMax in the field since November of last year, and we were trying to overcome paper in the field and getting paper back into the office to be able to streamline our billing process and take care of time-sensitive documents in a timely manner. Up to this point, our experience with WorkMax has been overall very positive. We have a very unique style of business, and finding a software solution to do exactly what we wanted was a really big challenge. We really like WorkMax for its ability to flex to our needs and integrate with unique systems we already had in place. So our top use case that we've been able to address with WorkMax is being able to have forms in the field instantly come into the office. And that's just been revolutionary for us. In addition, being able to update forms on the fly. So if a form needs specific information on it for a particular month or a particular customer, it's instantly updatable to the field. We don't have to bring in devices to update apps and things like that. Oh, Lordy. So before WorkMax, we had a two-part ticket where our techs in the field would have to fill out all of the information about what they did on the elevator at that time, whether it was service or repair. We had two different types of forms, and we were relying on them to put the correct address, the correct job number, the correct state number, everything that they did, and have it be legible for the office to read, and then make it back to the office within a reasonable amount of time without having coffee spilled on it, being run over by a truck, flying out in the middle of the road, shredded by a dog, all kinds of issues with paper. When we started with WorkMax, we didn't have a whole lot of resistance in the field. We had an app that we were previously using that we had custom built. Our biggest challenge was not an adaptation to technology. They actually really appreciated the WorkMax platform and how easy it was to use compared to the old software that we were using. It was pretty clunky and had a lot of redundant information that they needed to enter. But with WorkMax, they can just pick the job that they're on. It automatically populates the form that they need. They fill it out. They can use voice dictation. And a lot of times they're not even typing into the forms. When we launched WorkMax, it was very easy. It went super quick. I have a couple of our techs are on the older, they're a little older and maybe aren't as tech savvy as some of our other technicians. And even our older guys or those that aren't quite as tech savvy have had no problem with WorkMax. It's super easy, streamlined, easy to use, and they love it. When we first chose WorkMax as a solution, in one of the calls, I talked to the sales guy several times before we decided, okay, WorkMax seems like it could be a good idea for us. But the thing that sold WorkMax to us is he brought on an implementation guy onto our call. And I had expressed some of the challenges that I saw and some of the things that I needed. And he was very positive, very much, yes, we can do this. We'll sit down, we'll figure it out, and we'll take as long as it it needs to take to get it figured out for you. And we are very, very heavy form users. That's our number one use of WorkMax. And support has been awesome every time I contacted them. They're right on top of it. I think Tom in particular probably knows me by first name. I'm sure they talk about me in the office, but everybody's been great that I've talked to. The biggest thing that we've been able to eliminate with WorkMax is the processing of paper. When I talk about us having 600 elevators on service, that's at least 600 pieces of paper a month that come into the office. And that doesn't count repairs, any modernization that get done. Some sites have, we need multiple pieces of paper per elevator. So in the past, we were bringing all of those papers in and every single one had to be hand checked and scanned. So the amount of office labor clerical that we've been able to eliminate is huge. Just in scanning alone, we've eliminated 6 hours a month on the scanner. We were going through scanners. We have cement plants on service in the high desert, and the cement dust that would come back on the tickets would just eat the rollers on the scanners. It was in, and they're not cheap. They're expensive. Document scanners are expensive. The person that was doing the majority of the scanning is now able to reutilize her time and do more billing. So she went from a role that was strictly paper management and filing to now generating revenue and income for the business. So that's been a huge, I don't know how to quantify that, but it's definitely a good step forward. There was never a question for us whether or not WorkMax would eliminate jobs. If I don't want to say that it's created jobs. We've been able to shift and move in and recreate. Her time is not spent looking at paper or filing anymore. We still have to email customers copies, and there's still things that need to be done with the forms that are coming in. But they're also coming in immediately. We don't have to spend time tracking down these forms either. That's another huge thing with WorkMax, is once the form's created, it's a matter of minutes before it's in the office. We really like that WorkMax is in the cloud. That was one of the things that was super important to us. Not only that it was located in the cloud, but that our employees with the app on their device could work offline, because some of our, you know, machine rooms are in the basement, or they're in the, on the roof of the building, or they're in a remote location where they don't have cell service. It was a challenge that we had previously with our previous software, where they had to have service in order to be able to do anything. But with WorkMax, they can work completely offline. When they do get service, they can sync their device. But as far as storage in the cloud, we're being so small and me doing so many jobs and having a family life too, I'm able to work from home remotely and be able to answer questions on the weekend. It's a 24-hour business. People get in elevators all the time, 2 o'clock in the morning when somebody calls and says, hey, I'm stuck in an elevator. We go. And to be able to look at WorkMax and go, oh my gosh, somebody was just there yesterday. This is what happened. This is why, you know, this is what you need to look for. Or our employee being able to clock out at odd hours, and then me being able to look at it instantly and you know, say, oh my gosh, you know, they have 10 hours of overtime that I need to bill for right now. You know, that's really, really helpful. Sometimes we have very time sensitive forms. A customer will call us with an elevator that's been red tagged by the state, and that means that it cannot be used until we get paperwork into the office. And we used to either have our technician drive that paperwork in immediately, which we would have to pay them for, or they would have to send us a picture of the ticket that they had filled out, which never came out okay. You could never read it. You know, it's really tough in the field. But we have to have that paperwork in there before we can call the state and ask permission to turn the elevator back on. So it helps us not have to pay the employee to come back to the office with that paperwork. And also it helps our customer because they can get their elevator turned on faster. So one of the other things we really love about forms is the ability to put images into the form. We had a customer whose elevator, they had an entrapment in the elevator, and our technician did not beat the fire department there. And the fire department used the jaws of life to the elevator doors, and it turned into an insurance claim for our customer. But because we had those pictures time stamped when they were taken, we were able to prove that we were not at fault and what time everything happened. And so then the customer was able to file the claim with their insurance company. That was insane. We have the video too, because he was able to put the video in the forms. Previously with paper, sometimes it would take a month to get a paper ticket back in the office. It was ridiculous because they would lose the paper. They would forget where they put it. Then they would have to redo it because they lost it. Now with WorkMax, we're able to send a quote out to the customer, dispatch a technician, get a ticket, a work ticket back saying that they completed the work, bill out the customer all in the same day. It's fabulous. One of the challenges for us moving away from paper was a pushback from an older generation about a distrust in technology and the thought that our customers wouldn't accept digital signatures, digital information. But what we found, overwhelmingly, is that our customers, not only do they trust and like their information back to them digitally, they actually prefer it. They don't want a yellow paper ticket anymore. They don't know what to do with it. But if you send them an email with whatever it was that you did with your form that your tech has filled out, they'll file that in their computer. They'll leave it in their inbox. They don't care, but they don't have this yellow piece of paper that they don't know what to do with anymore. And even some of our very large customers, in particular our cement plants that have all kinds of processes for paying and paperwork that has to get done, they were immediately receptive to having all of this done digitally. Part of our process is that elevators have to be visited every month for service. And we used to have to wait for those service tickets to come back into the office before we knew whether or not they had been serviced. Now, papers can get lost. We don't know if the elevator's been serviced until that paper gets back. Some customers require that paper in order to pay their bill. So if, say, our technician A forgot to go to that job, completely missed going to that job, or lost that paper ticket, that was revenue that was completely lost. But because WorkMax is so immediate with information, we can check every day against the jobs that have to get serviced and whether or not they've been done. So about halfway through the month, we go through the list and make sure anything that we need a ticket for to bill is been has been done, and we have immediate information without having to call five people and say, hey, did you go to, you know, this hotel and get that elevator serviced? Because of WorkMax, our techs do not have to bring paperwork back to the office. So that we have one employee that lives 60 miles from our office in the greater LA area. So if you know anything about Southern California, there's LA and then there's everything else. And he is closer to LA than we are. We are not in LA. And for to pay him to drive from where he lives back to us is about an hour and a half. It costs us a lot of money for him to drive paperwork from his house back to us. So he's able to only come into the office about once a month for random things rather than once a week or more often to drop paperwork off, especially if it's important paperwork like a red tag or something. All right, we have five mechanics that can avoid being in the office an average of 4 hours a week in drive time, which is a savings of 1,040 hours a year. And that savings is $20,000 per employee per year. Now, if those five guys are working in the field instead of driving, we can bill an extra $56,000 each year per employee. If we look at what we've saved with travel time alone using WorkMax, we've seen an ROI of 40 times year over year, and that doesn't even take into account wage increases that we're going to see in the next year. So at Executive Elevator, we have about 70 forms that are all different, customized per customer or per job type or per work type. We also have some internal forms, and then we have forms just for employee information, whether that's their emergency card, their clock out forms. We have notes for jobs if there's after hours access information or something that needs to come back on a particular job. The awesome thing about WorkMax that we have really come to love is the subforms. So if we have a form and let's say a tech is on a job and he sees a problem with the elevator, sometimes we don't need that customer facing. It's, hey, this button needs to be replaced. We'll just do it on the next service. If we make that customer facing, the customer is going to have a problem with it. It's really not a safety issue. It's just something that we need to take care of next service. So what we do is we have a form that's triggered with a button. So after they're finished filling out their service ticket, then another form comes up, which we call in our office a deficiency form, and they'll be able to fill that out. Comes back to us, and then we put it in another system so it goes back out to the field so that they know during the next service that say the button needs to get fixed. But the ability for those subforms that are internal and not customer facing, we love them. We have so many of them. Executive Elevator, we pride ourselves in being a boutique type company. There are other options for our customers in elevator service, in particularly they're very large companies. So we try and maintain a very personal relationship with our customers. When they pick up the phone, they get an owner. And so when we have this relationship between our tech and our customer, and I think it tells volumes about us as a business, when our employee hands the customer a tablet to sign or to see information about their elevator, as opposed to a wrinkled piece of paper or something that's been floating around in their truck. I think it just provides a more professional look for us. And then when we send those forms back out via email to our customers as a receipt, they're able to see timestamps, pictures of what's going on, and signatures of who approved the work. Elevators are kind of a mystery to a lot of people. It's not something like a car that a lot of people know, you know, what parts are. So by having pictures on forms, being able to really spell out what went on with their elevator, they feel like they're getting what they're paying for. Forms are really, really easy to build. I'm updating forms all the time. They it took me no time at all to figure it out. I don't think they're hard at all. There's a couple nuances that you have to know when you're building them, but in general, no. They're very, very easy. And I'm constantly updating. I just did an update today. Sometimes I'll get feedback from the field saying, hey, we need to put a picture on this ticket. In particular, we had one form that didn't have a place to put a picture, to attach a picture. And I got a call from the field saying, hey, we really need to send a picture to the customer on this ticket. So I said, hey, hold on, give me 10 minutes. And I was able to update the form. They resynced their iPad. They were able to fill it out and put a picture on the ticket. And it's that fast. Our implementation was extremely complicated. And when we sat down to start implementation, Gareth started going through the script of training. And I started asking questions. And within maybe 20 minutes, he said, okay, you drive. You tell me what you need. You tell me what WorkMax needs to do. And so it was completely driven by me. He started listening and we put together something completely custom that he said he'd never done before. We had some legacy stuff that we really couldn't step away from when we started with WorkMax. It's not our single source of data. We have a Microsoft Access database that was built in 2005. So it's on the older side. And it was very important for us to be able to integrate that database with WorkMax. And through a lot of hard work and dedication and twice weekly meetings, Gareth and I were able to figure out how to integrate my ancient Access database with WorkMax completely seamlessly, so that if we update information in my Access database, every night there's a script that runs that launches ConnectMax and pushes updates to WorkMax, and it works beautifully. Embedding media is awesome. I don't know what other words to use. We use embedded media and forms all the time, especially when a specific part is needed to be ordered. We service elevators of all make and models, and they have all kinds of different parts, and some of them are very specific. So a tech in the field can take pictures of a part, attach them to a parts request form, and comes right to the office. We can start sourcing parts right away without having to lose pictures or, you know, try and cross-reference information. And then that data is stored for that job. So when we have to order it again in the future, it's already there. Something I really like with the online portal is that forms can come in as drafts. And so if there's something that needs to be adjusted or fixed, or somebody talked into their device and it came up with some word that didn't make sense, you can fix it before it goes out to the customer. So that's been very nice, because I think last week we had a form come in with the word spaghetti on it, and I'm pretty sure there's no spaghetti in elevators.